folks, Will from MinIO here, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to set up Prometheus and connect it back to your MinIO cluster so that you can get detailed history of what's going on in your MinIO cluster at any given time. Let's dive right in. So the first thing we're going to do is we need to generate the Prometheus configuration, and this is easy enough to do. I just do an mc admin Prometheus generate. And I need to give it the alias of what I'm going to be monitoring, and that's going to be MinIO1. This gives me my scrape config. It's got the job name. That's going to be important for later. And it also has a bearer token. So this is actually going to be an authenticated call to my HTTPS MinIO1 API. Make sure you're calling your API port, not your console port. Console port won't work. And then this metrics path, that's just the directory that gets pulled whenever I want to do a scrape. So easy enough. What I need to do with this is I'm going to copy and paste it into my Prometheus config. And that is in a directory here, vi config Prometheus. And right now, all it has in it is this global scrape. It's going to come in and try to do a scrape every 15 seconds. And it's been doing that ever since I fired up this lab environment because there was nothing for it to scrape. Now I'm giving it an actual scrape config. And here's my full config. Again, exactly what I just did. So we're going to go ahead and save that. Now what I need to do is I need to restart Prometheus. And I've got this running in a Docker container. So if I just restart Prometheus, and then the next thing we'll do is we'll go ahead and take a look at our Prometheus server. So here is my Prometheus environment. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do a little query to make sure that I'm actually getting the records, to make sure this is all actually working. So if I go ahead and put in a little expression here, I'm going to look for the MinIO cluster disk online total. Note that it's part of the job MinIO job. That's the job name that we set up. And I just want to see anything that's happened in the last 5 minutes. If I go ahead and execute this, well, there you go. I've got a few hits. So it's actually pulling back the data for me. So we are in good shape with all of this. So now let's come back over and take a look at my metrics. Now, this same page that I had before is still here. It's still the point in time. It's not showing all the latest details. I've generated some traffic on this so we have something to actually monitor. But if I do a sync, this will actually show me, yes, I've got an object and I've got a bucket up there now and everything is working. But again, this is just point in time stuff. Let's go ahead and take a look at my usage. There we go. One bucket, one object. I have this data usage growth. My object size distribution is just one object, very small object there. And then I've got my API data received rate. I've got all this data coming in. I've got the data sent rate. I can also see in my traffic what's been going on here, the various commands that have been happening here, making buckets and all that other fun stuff. Any errors that are coming in, I can see all of this detail now because of my Prometheus server that I've set up. And that's really everything that there is to see as far as setting up Prometheus goes. It's very simple to do. You set up that scrape config, you restart Prometheus, you set up your MinIO server to make those callbacks using the MinIO Prometheus URL and the Prometheus job ID, and then you're good to go. Everything you want to see is already there for you. So that is our video demonstration. And if you've enjoyed it, I hope you will reach out with us. You can use any of the methods you see here on the screen. If you'd like to chat with us interactively, you can chat with us on slack.min.io. Or you can just leave a comment here on the video. Thank you, and we'll see you for the next one.